Things are never what they seem. Not if you know how to look. My name is Tom, and I know how to look. We live in uneven times, my friends. Uneven times. So little makes sense these days. And that makes me wonder. Wonder what it all means. I wonder what you see when you see me. It may not seem like I have a lot, but I always have my art, a smile, and a question. Am I a man or a marionette? Is this a shopping cart or a palace? And with these three things, the world is indeed a wondrous place. Don't believe me? Well, let's start by welcoming my very special guest, our master of ceremonies, President Barack Obama.
It's great to have you all here to marvel at the seven wonders of the modern world. Do you want to know what I wonder about? In this big, huge, gigantic world, no matter how much we laugh or fight at times, no matter how far apart or close together we are, no matter how many different colors, shapes, and sizes we come in, we all have something very important in common, our beginnings. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you the Madonna of the DNA.
Which you can't see. But the truth is that I live in you and you all live in me. How is it possible, you ask? How can this be? It's because of these strands that run through all of us. They are what makes us a we. What are these strands I'm speaking of? Funny you should ask. They're called DNA. And they make our lives their task. They determine what color our skin, our eyes, and even our hair will be. They also decide if we'll have a grumpy disposition or be as sweet as a pea. Place in time. What we decide to do with that gift, however, well, now, that decision is all yours.
Well said. Madam, I hear scientists are doing pretty interesting things with DNA these days.
It's true. In fact, here is one of those interesting things now. Clones.
To my best girl, Miss Minty. Miss Minty, blah, 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 blah. Please, come on out here and say hi to these fine folks.
How are you doing, fine folks?
Are you ready to bubble the place up, my lady, as I swoon and croon your favorite tune?
Oh, Bing, you know I love the way you sing.
Well, let me not keep you waiting. A one, a two, a one, two.
2, 3.
Strangers in the night, exchanging glances, wandering in the night. What were the chances we'd be sharing of before the night was through? Something in your eyes was so inviting, something in that smile was so exciting, something in those teeth told me to brush with you.
If I remember correctly, that is exactly how it was. And calling was so expensive, people used to have to write letters.
Can you imagine that? Did you use plumes and ink bottles to write on scrolls and send them by messenger pigeon?
Not quite, but almost, Mr. President. I am, however, still young enough to appreciate a wonder.
No doubt.
May I?
Please, do.
Each time I see a little phone with buttons, touchscreens, and cases, I can't resist a joyous urge to dial up and say, thank heaven for little phones. For little phones get smarter every day. Thank heaven for little phones. They develop in the most delightful ways. Those little phones are pretty and appealing. When they are flashing, send you crashing to the ceiling. Thank heaven for little phones. Then I can pick up and dial just to say hello. Thank
With all the amazing ways we can communicate nowadays, you'd think miscommunication would be a thing of the past. Not for our next wonders. The bobby pins were created to keep our hair neatly in place so that we can see clearly. But this pair seemed to be able to do everything but that.
You did not say 4 o'clock.
Except that I did. I even wrote it down in my book. The ladies were so upset when we weren't there. There wasn't a hair in the place.
How could there be? We weren't there.
I was.
Honestly, Fred, you drive me crazy.
Well, you gave me the map to crazy the minute we met.
What are we doing, Fred? We can't seem to ever get it together. The world's hair has gone wild, and you and I can't seem to do a thing about it. A fine romance with no hair, that's a fine romance. Love hat strings, we should be picking up girls that all think out flowers. But you scheduled us wrong, and I missed the party by hours.
A fine romance without dancing. A fine romance without hair enhancing. Might as well have stayed pinned in my cardboard stands. I haven't got a chance. This is a fine romance.
A fine romance with no fixes. A fine romance, my friend. This is, we should be cozier than 2 peas in a small pot. Instead, we're yapping like 2 fools trying to play God.
Yes, a fine romance with all glitches. A fine romance with no hitches. We should be interlocked like a chain link fence. We haven't got a chance. This is a fine romance.
To meet my friend, Sadie. She looks dainty, doesn't she? So airy and graceful. She lives in a dream right now. That dream is so, so high in the sky that without a telescope, she barely seems like a flicker to
to us mere mortals, but she was dreamt to protect us all. See, sometimes adults get crazy ideas when they fight. They build ugly bombs and make even uglier threats. And there's only one way to fight ugly, by being as pretty as Sadie, with her pretty little pirouettes and her lovely split kicks. She has the power to blow a bomb right out of the sky without it ever getting near us. She's so good that we won't even know when she does it. We'll just keep going on with our happy lives and let those with less imagination fight and toil, while Sadie keeps on flying through the stars, turning bombs into bubbles and troubles into dust.
And now, I would like to introduce a wonder that is near and dear to my heart, as in many ways is what introduced me to all of you. The internet has been in the making for years, but I don't think anybody could have imagined what a huge part of our lives it would become. It's on our computers, our TVs, even on our phones, and ladies and gentlemen, the internet.
Sure, they ask you for money, but once you find them, I have to get them for you, day or night. 24/7, I have people clicking on me, looking to buy a book, a pair of garden shears, vitamins.
You think you've got a bad Amazon app?
I search for old friends, make new ones, I post pictures, tell people what they have for lunch, where they're up to. It never stops. People always need information on each other. Most important, they need each other. Between the three of us, we ain't got it covered. Besides, would you bet anything else?
I suppose you're right. We may not have an easy one, and also we never have before.
You might as well enjoy it, ladies, because you can tap your way to happen. want to ask you guys something. At the count of three, I want every single person here to call out the one thing that you guys think all of these wonders have in common. Are you ready?
Yes.
I can't hear you.
Yes.
Okay. At the count of three, what is the one thing that all these wonders have in common? One, two, three. Well done. I'm going to tell you the one thing I think they all have in common. They all managed to change the way we live in this world. Some of the ideas were simple. Some were born out of necessity. Some were purely a folly of somebody's imagination. But they all changed the world for the better. Now that change didn't come quickly or easily. And it didn't happen on its own. For any wonder to truly shine, it needs all of us to believe in it. And when we do, wow! It's a wonderful world. Mr. Armstrong, would you be so kind?
My pleasure, Mr. President. My pleasure.
Colors of